So, coal.
You probably know the basics. It's a rock mined underground, burned for electricity, and it's failing. There used to be more coal mines, more coal plants, and more coal jobs. But why? What happened?
The answer, in part, is robots.
Coal mining job-killing machines have replaced coal miners for decades. They helped make the industry more productive, but at the price of people's jobs. That shift from miners to machines is mostly done. The problems today come from natural gas, which, thanks to fracking, is currently cheap. And cheap gas hurts coal. In fact, if you compare the costs of power from coal against natural gas, about 1 in 4 coal units is operating uneconomically. They're closing because they're too expensive to run. Politicians love to blame regulations and the EPA. But in reality, machines took the mining jobs and gas closed the plants. The EPA only played a bit part. If you're a miner or a coal plant operator, that's scary. But let's not be nostalgic. Since 1900, more than 100,000 coal miners have died in America. More dead men and women than all the American deaths in the Vietnam War and the 2 Iraq wars combined. Burning coal is also a leading cause of acid rain, smog, and global warming, and is linked with everything from developmental problems in children to neurological issues, asthma, and cancer. That's an unacceptable burden to local communities who bear the brunt of the pollution. Now, sure, coal is less dirty than it used to be. Thanks to protections from the EPA, most plants are now removing mercury, lead, and other toxins from their smoke. But at a fundamental level, coal is not and never will be clean. The good news is there are alternatives. There's natural gas, which carries its own risks and it's not a long-term climate solution, but there's also wind and solar. They've been here for decades and, combined with other clean energy technology, provide a model that's simply better than coal. Any way you slice it, economically, environmentally, jobs, climate, health, renewables and efficiency absolutely have the upper hand. Now, transitions are never easy. More coal plants and mines will close, and the people that depended on them deserve recognition and support. But the momentum is clear. Renewables are here to stay. Coal is on the way out.